Father would come together. And as we sing a song like this, I pray that each and every one truly, truly understands what we celebrate this time of the year for. Yes, Father, it is a good time to family get together and enjoy fellowship with one another. But Father, it's about the birth of your Son who came and gave his life for each and every one of us. We thank you, Lord, for this. Lord, take charge of this service. Be with those that couldn't be with us for whatever reason it might be. Bless them. Let them know that they are in our prayers. It's in my Son's precious name we pray. Amen.
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 May you see it. In the way of announcements, quite a few announcements for the month of December coming up. Of course, hopefully everyone will stay today. We will have our Christmas banquet in the back in the kitchen area after the morning worship. On the 17th of December here in St. Tammany Parish, there's a half a day of school, so of course that's a Friday where they have a half a day. And then from then on until after the 1st, sometime after the 1st, they'll come back to school. So they'll be off from the 20th to the 31st. Here in St. Tammany Parish for the Christmas New Year break, so be aware of that. The 22nd and the 29th of December, we will not have Wednesday night Bible study, so be aware of that. Of course, the 22nd is 3 days before Christmas, and the 29th is a few days, of course, before the New Year as well. Usually off on that, those nights, and people prepare things, so no Wednesday night service for those two. So we will have Wednesday night service this coming Wednesday for all who would like to come, have Bible study and fellowship and food as well as we come together this coming Wednesday night. Christmas Eve, we'll have a Christmas Eve service here at Bayou Baptist Church for all who would like to come at 6 p.m. We usually have quite a few songs that we'll sing, Christmas songs together as far as that, and just a little bit of Word of God, from Word of God. But mostly we're going to be singing Christmas songs and coming together to remember Christmas. So we'll have Christmas Eve service this on Friday the 24th of December, of course, and then Christmas this year falls on a Saturday. So be aware of that. We are collecting for Lottie Moon. You have offering envelopes there. If you'd like to give over and above what you get for the working of this church, you can do that, whatever you'd like to give. And this is work that is being done by the Southern Baptist missionaries internationally, abroad. And it's not just spreading the gospel, it's also through this, they also help people who are in need in these different countries as well. Whether it's clothing, whether it's medical help, or whether it's other things that take place. So it's not just spreading of the word, but it's also we're helping to with the people that are in need there as well. So if you would like to, you can give to that as well. We have about 6 calendars, I think, that's left, and I don't know how long they'll last. But if you'd like to have a calendar for the new year of 2022, there are about 6 of them left at $5 each, and you can purchase those there. For those who have not heard and do not know, the casino bill was defeated last night. So 37,000 were against it, 22,000 were for it, so it did not pass. So the casino that was supposedly proposed to be built in Eden Isles is not going to be built because the parish, St. Tammany Parish, voted everything down. So if you have not gotten the results, that is basically the official results. So just so you know concerning that. Clarence, what about the Slidell police chief? Was he re-elected or not?
Not yet.
Okay. Is that not, wasn't that yesterday?
No.
When is that?
I'm not sure exactly when that is.
I thought you said March.
Oh, is that not till March? I see the signs already up, and I'm saying...
Oh, they put those up way...
Yeah, I just assumed, so I guess I'm getting it wrong again, and that's okay, but he's up for reelection. Okay, okay, so that's coming in March. Okay, good to know that. I mean, I didn't read when, it just said reelect.
I wasn't sure if he was able to run again.
Oh, yeah, this is only his third, this is his second term.
I thought it was his third, but,
This is...
I know he's going against...
This is his third term?
Yeah, he's going against...
I thought you only could do two terms.
I thought you could too, so I was wondering.
Are we talking, hold on.
Talking about Brady Fannin.
Okay. This is his first term. Brady Fannin.
That was his first term, this is gonna be his, if he gets reelected, it'll be his second term, yes.
Yeah, I don't know why I thought...
Yes, yes.
He's trying to get Brett Rodriguez, which was Mr. Max, which was city chair for years.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I just, as long as I, because I didn't see anything, and I said, I didn't realize it. Because we can't vote on it, because we're in the parish.
We're in the parish.
Yeah, we're not in the city.
I know.
So we don't get to vote on the chief of police. So yes, that's why it wasn't on our ballot, so anyway, so that's what's going on there. So be aware of that. You can find us on Facebook and also on YouTube as well. Any other announcements that we need to be aware of anything else going on in our community or in our area as well? I can't think of anything else that is going to be taking place. Before Al comes and leads us in another hymn, let me share with you a hymn from the hymn book and one that goes along with the message as well. Familiar one, it's O Come, O Come, Emmanuel. And again, as I sing this, just pay attention to the words, or you follow along if you want. It's hymn number 76 is to where it is in your hymn book. And the words there are fulfilling the prophecy of the Old Testament. O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel, that mourns in lonely exile here, until the Son of God appears. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O come, thou day spring, calm and cheer our spirits by thine advent here. Disperse the gloomy clouds of night and death's dark shadows put to flight. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou wisdom from on high, and offer all things far and nigh. To us the path of knowledge show, and cause her in her ways to go. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, desires of nations bind all peoples in one heart and mind. Bid envy, strife, and quarrel cease. Fill the whole world with heaven's peace. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Remember, Emmanuel means God with us. And that's what was born on Christmas that we celebrate. God coming from heaven, being born of a virgin. Let us continue then as Al comes now and leads us to another hymn, hymn number 113, We Three Kings of Orient Are. And different ones as well on there. Today is a sad time for many people, and I'd like you to pray for the many people throughout the five states that were hit by this tornado. I think it was yesterday that hit five states: Kentucky, Illinois, Tennessee, Arkansas, and Missouri. Hundreds of people, we think, were killed. Do this. There was a lot of casualties, a lot of devastation. Businesses, buildings, churches were destroyed or damaged. So I'd ask you to remember what they are going through in these states and maybe other states as well that were hit by this tornado. We are all familiar with devastation and what it goes through as we. Many of us have just gone through Hurricane Ida and And we go through hurricanes from time to time and what dealing with, so you know what they're dealing with. And I'd ask you to keep them in prayer and pray for the many people there, and especially those who have lost a loved one. Pray for the people there in their loss, and pray for God's grace and comfort in their life as they are now without someone who is very close to them. So remember them in prayer. Brian and Mandy are under the weather today, so pray for Brian and Mandy. Newton in prayer as they're under the weather, so remember them in prayer. Pray for our dear sister, Sarah. Sarah will be having surgery this coming Thursday. Slidell Memorial, is that right?
No.
Where?
Ashna.
Okay, Ashna here or in Jefferson?
Here.
Here. Okay, the Ashna Hospital in Jeff, on Gore's down that way. So pray for her. She will be having kidney surgery. They're going to be taking out, the left kidney, is that right?
Yes.
Yeah. Taking out that. So we'll keep you in prayer with that.
Thank you all.
Pray for Johnny and Debbie Garrett. It's good to have them with us. Johnny's in the back with the video and Debbie's there. But they'll be leaving Friday and going back to Kentucky to be with mom and their family. Pray for them as well, mom, sisters, brothers, and other family members in Kentucky. Pray for Johnny. He will be going to the doctor, Tuesday and Wednesday?
Monday and Tuesday.
Monday and Tuesday. Okay, so pray for him. He gets a shot on Tuesday?
Yes.
At Tulane, yes. So pray for him as he will be getting a shot, and they continue to treat him for his cancer. So do pray for him and remember him, and as well as Debbie in prayer, what they are all going through also. Many others in prayer, we want to remember, pray for those who are not with us this morning for whatever reason. Again, we mentioned some are sick, some may be working, and others, I don't know. They're just not here, but we keep them in prayer as well. Other prayer requests, concerns, Thanksgiving, or whatever you would like to share with us this morning. Anyone or anything? Linda?
Prayer of Thanksgiving. For the last 2 weeks, my daughter and her family's cycled viruses and everything else, and it's been horrible. I've been having to take care of everybody. And then Danny got a little cold and was coughing and wheezing real bad, but kept him out of the hospital, right? Doctor and him.
That's good.
So he's feeling a lot better today and yesterday. And so just remember all them and everybody else. I mean, that virus just hits you like a brick.
But did they have COVID or just had flu?
No, it was a stomach virus.
Stomach virus.
And it lasted like 3 days.
Is that right?
Yeah. And first of all, Kelly's 9-year-old got it, and then the baby got it, and then Kelly got it, and then Mia got it, and so it was just like
it went around, huh?
Yeah. Oh, I'm like, Lord. I take a lot of vitamins, so thankfully, I guess I'm this one.
Good. We'll keep you on prayer. We'll keep everybody else in prayer. And it's all this hot and cold weather stuff that people.
That's what gets Danny sick.
Getting sick. So, it's hot one day, cold the next day. It's like yesterday. We were, in the morning, we were 80 degrees, and by the evening time, it was in the 50s. And then tonight, and then this morning, you wake up, it's in the 40s. So it's kind of hard for your body to get acclimated into that. So.
It's Louisiana.
That's it. This is typical now. So. But we want to remember many in prayer. We sure will.
At least it's not 110 every day. So.
That's right. Oh, that's right.
I'll take it.
That's right. At least it can feel a little bit like Christmas, right?
Exactly. It does. I've enjoyed this year a little more than any of them.
That's right.
And I'm not working.
Well, don't worry. You may get there. Other prayer requests. Thank you.
Keep my son Sean in prayer.
How's he doing with the kidney stones?
He has a kidney stone.
Yes.
It's 10 millimeters.
Right.
And he also has a hernia in the same kidney.
Oh, Lord.
So they're going in mid-January and do two surgeries.
You're going to wait that long?
I know. Go figure. To break up and remove the one stone and to do whatever they got to do to the hernia. So he's in a lot of pain.
Listen, I know, yes.
Just keep him in prayer. Mm.
I feel his pain now. Yeah, I know his pain. Yes,
it's a long time to have to suffer, though.
I know. I can't figure out why they decided to wait. I mean,
yes,
He's already been in pain for a month and a half.
I know it, yes. Well, we'll keep him in prayer and you in prayer as well, because you've got to deal with it too, with him.
Actually, he's not hard to deal with.
Okay,
Sean
sure.
Pretty much suffers in silence.
In silence. I couldn't. I didn't talk in silence. Why the pain? It hurt. It hurt. It's painful. So I know, like I said, yes, but we'll keep him in prayer. Other prayer requests. Danny.
Friend of Renee's family, Sarah Wright, Tennessee, she passed away overnight. I think it was Friday night. They found her Saturday morning.
Uh-huh.
So just keep the family up there.
We sure will. Yeah, absolutely. We sure will. And I also remember your wife's family up that way as well. How's everybody doing up that way? What did you know?
We're still alive.
How are things at NASA?
We need prayer out there.
Okay.
You know, right now it's a struggle.
Okay.
And workforce, we're losing a lot of people.
Wow, okay.
So the turnover is just, and you can't build a rocket when you're turning people over 3 months.
Yeah, if you don't have enough people, I mean, I think, yeah.
Not enough people, not enough experienced people.
Right.
You know, it makes it a real, real challenge.
Oh, I bet it does, yeah. Not just anybody can go in there and do that, that's right. Exactly, yeah. Yeah, so we'll remember you and the workforce at NASA. We sure will. Other prayer requests. Janet?
For Candace Briggs.
Yes.
And also for her family.
Okay.
And ours in turn, because we're
Yeah. Remember Candace in prayer. She's having a very rough time right now, and things are not looking too good. So we want to remember her as well as the family. We sure will. Yes. Other prayer requests?
Just continued prayer for each one of our family.
Prayer yes.
Thanksgiving. Dolores' eyes seem to be doing pretty well. And also a prayer Thanksgiving that Anna Mae is doing so much better.
Yeah, she's back there. Yeah.
Oh, I know. I gave her a hug.
Yeah, she's back
but
there.
But just a prayer Thanksgiving that she's yeah. doing well. And, you know, and a prayer Thanksgiving just to be here this morning. Have Billy with us.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. With us. Yeah. Yeah, when I went to go see her this past week in the hospital, she was ready to go home.
I
was up there. How was that? Man, you up there saying, can I go home? I want to go home.
Yeah, who does that sound like?
All of us. All of us. But a prayer of thanks. I'm glad that she. No more episodes, right?
No, I'm doing well.
Oh, good. Well, good. Prayer of thanks. I'm glad that you're doing better. Awesome. Good. Sandy Dio, any more updates on your knee, on Brenda?
Yes, I talked to her last night. She had the stress test, and it came out abnormal. But the one before that also was abnormal.
Okay.
She has a doctor's appointment on the 20th.
Okay.
Discussing with them.
Is she doing okay, or is she still having pain, or?
She didn't say she was having pain.
She didn't say,
pain.
Of course, if you don't ask, you won't say, right?
Yeah, that's true.
That's like with all of us.
Like
yeah, that's right. But remember Brenda Gladys in prayer, because she does have some heart issues that's going on, maybe have even some blockages, since it is abnormal. So we'll see, right?
Yeah.
So pray for her. Linda.
Prayer of Thanksgiving also for Wendy. She's doing really good. She went back to work Monday.
Wow.
For a few hours.
Okay.
And then, well, she owns her own business, so she can.
But
if
that's
she don't
still
want
good.
To work, she can go home.
Yes.
But I told her, I said, we try not to overdo it. Just work right. a few hours. And so she's been back doing a lot of things. So
that's
I'm
good.
Going to check it back in a couple months and see how it's doing.
Prayer of thanks. Prayer of thanks.
She's
good.
Doing
good. Awesome. Any others? Any other prayers, concerns, Thanksgiving? Just pray for each other, of course, during this holiday season. It is getting hectic out there, and it's going to get even worse as it gets closer to Christmas. Pray for all the people in the retail who are dealing with the people, especially as it gets closer to Christmas and everything is all scooped up and everybody gets upset and angry because they can't get what they want because they waited till the last minute to get things. And so pray for the many in the retail business, as well as everyone that's in any kind of form of business as well, because it seems as though around the holidays, everything gets hectic, everything and everybody. So just pray for each other, remember each other in prayer with all of that. Again, traveling mercies for all who are traveling and will be traveling over these holiday seasons coming from now until after the first of the year, as many will be traveling, visiting family, friends, or whatever the case may be. Just pray for that. Pray for the many people who do not know Jesus Christ as we celebrate Christmas and celebrate the time we set aside to remember the birth of Jesus, where many who do not know Jesus, to them it's just another holiday. But for us, it's celebrating the birth of God coming down and being born of a virgin to die on a cross for our sins. And as always, give thanks to the Lord. I know you may be going through some very hectic times sometimes. You may be stressed out, or things may happen, but I would tell you is give thanks to the Lord and keep the faith. Keep the faith. Just remember. You know, and again, I put it out there, I do this from time to time, and just let you know, we need to be like Daniel. We need to just continue to pray to the Lord 3 times a day and give him thanks. I tell people, you know, yeah, we can be like Job and persevere, and that's another one as well. But I like Daniel too, because Daniel was in slavery all of his life, and he never gave up on God. And it says it was his habit, or was his all what he always did. He always prayed to the Lord 3 times a day, giving thanks to the Lord. And he did this, and he lived to be 90 years old before he was out of slavery from Babylon. And I guess, and I'm thinking he got to be back home, and there he died in his hometown. So just give thanks to the Lord. I know you may be going through some difficult times, or I think maybe too much sometimes. And especially pray for those who are going through hectic times of, say, depression or stress or whatever the case may be during the holiday season. The loss of a loved one, finances, or whatever may be going on. Pray for them. And remember them in prayer. Pray for each other. Pray for each other and all that we do. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Almighty God, as we come now, Lord, we lift up all these prayers, all the concerns, the many things that are going on in all of our lives and all of our families and friends, and the many things that are taking place. We pray for your grace, for your mercy, and for your help. Lord, we lift up at this time all the many, many people throughout these 5 states that have been devastated by this tornado. All of these in Kentucky, Illinois, Arkansas, Missouri, as well as Tennessee, and maybe other places as well, where destruction has happened and even the loss of lives that have taken place. And we pray you comfort the people who have lost a loved one in this tragic. Be with them, help them, comfort them, and watch over them as well. We pray for your help and for your grace upon us. Lord, we pray and we lift up all the prayers that have been mentioned here this morning. Johnny, as he continues his battle with his cancer, as he gets treatments this week, be with him, be with Debbie, be with Debbie's family in Kentucky, mom, sister, brothers, and family members. Be with the Wright family as this one has passed away, and we pray for the family and to be with them as well. We pray for Miss Sarah, and we lift her up as she will be having surgery this coming Thursday. And we pray, Lord, your help and your grace upon her, and be with her this coming week and also during the time of the surgery, and let her know that you are there with her as well. Again, we lift up all the prayers that have been mentioned and have been voiced. Candace, we pray for her and the family. Be with her, Lord, and help her. We pray for your grace. Many prayers of thanksgiving, where prayers have been answered, and we thank you, Lord, for that. We pray for the many here who are dealing with different health issues and health problems, and many who are maybe even listening online or looking online, and they too have health issues. And we lift them up before you, and we pray for them, and we ask for healing, for grace, for mercy, and for help in their lives. We pray, Lord, for the many, many people who do not know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. We pray for salvation, a friend, a coworker, a family member, or a stranger, any who are in need of Jesus Christ. Again, we lift up all the prayers, all the concerns, and the many that have been spoken and unspoken alike, and we pray for your help, grace, and mercy. All of this we ask in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let us stand at this time as Al comes and leads in our offertory hymn, hymn number 118, What Child Is This? Morning. Turn, if you will, to Matthew chapter 1, looking at verses 18 through 25. To many of you, this is a very familiar passage concerning Joseph and what God had spoken to or spoken to him through a dream. Again, as we will celebrate Christmas in about 13 days, here we have the account of what took place with Joseph, who is and will become the husband of Mary. Now, not much is known about Joseph. We have very little information from the Word of God. Really, he's only talked of here in Matthew and then again in Luke, a couple of chapters there, and they're here in Matthew, a couple of chapters here, and that's basically all we know concerning him. We do know he was a carpenter, and later Jesus, as he grows older, is known as the son of the carpenter. And that's all we know. Again, we know very little concerning what he had, who he was, but it does seem that sometime between the time Jesus was 12 years old and 30 years old, we have no record of him, and even after, when Jesus begins his ministry, nothing is told to us concerning Joseph. So the general consensus among the scholars is that somewhere between that time period, it's possible that Joseph passed away, that he died, even before Jesus began his ministry with it. But here we have the account of what took place when indeed Mary became pregnant with child by the Holy Spirit, and what Joseph's intentions were, and what he was going to do, and what his plans were, and how we see that those plans that he had was not in accordance with the plans of God, and how God visited him and what took place. So we read here from Matthew chapter 1, and in verse 18 and following, and if you notice verses 18 and 19 concerning Joseph, it says Joseph was a righteous man. Now notice it says, this is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Now, because Joseph was a righteous man and did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. Now, again, it's interesting here, the little we know, but what we do know is that Joseph was a righteous man. Now, there are a lot of people that we read about in both the Old and the New Testament that are considered righteous people. Now, what is a righteous man? What is a righteous person? I believe it's a person who believes in Jehovah God and follows the commands of God to the best of their ability. That doesn't mean that they were sinless. It doesn't mean they were perfect. But it does mean is that they strive to do the things of God, just as so many that you read about, Noah, Abraham, Joshua, Moses, you know, the list goes on of different people that you may read about in your reading who are righteous people. And he worshiped God. And Joseph was, and I believe, even though it's not told to us as well, as we see here, it says, before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. So Joseph, who didn't want to expose her to public disgrace, had in mind to divorce her quietly. Understand, back then, when two people were pledged to be married, the only way that pledge could be broken was through an official divorce. It's like a husband and wife get married today, and if they want to end it, they have to go to the court, right? And they have to get a divorce. Well, the same way here. They had to go before the priest or whatever and officially say, we want a divorce. Even though Joseph had no relations with her. And this is, so here he is. Mary, here he is, he finds out. Now, whether he found out by Mary maybe he saw the little baby bump, I don't know, because it's been a couple of months now. Remember, she went by her cousin Elizabeth, and she was there for a few months. And then she came home, okay? So there's no telling what he was thinking or what was taking place. But what he did know was that this child that Mary was carrying was not his. He did not have any relations with her at all because, why? He was a righteous man. He was a man who obeyed the commands of God. And there was no way that he was going to have any relations before they officially got married, even though they were pledged to be married. There was no way that he was going to do this because he knew this was against God's command. And he was a man who was to follow the things of God. So Joseph was still in love with Mary. And again, I like what it says there. He says he's a righteous man, and he did not want to expose her to public disgrace. See, he didn't want to do these things just to hurt her. I don't know, like again, I don't know if she told him, because it's not told to us, that what she was carrying was of the Holy Spirit and was by God, or whether he just assumed that while she was going away, she was unfaithful. And that's the only thing that we can come across as far as this. And he didn't have all the information. He assumed these many things. So he had his mind all made up. It was made up. He was asleep on it. The next day, he was going to get up. And usually with two witnesses, and go and do this privately to where everything was going. So again, he was going to do this. Again, what we have to understand is that in our life, sometimes things are not always what it seems. So we need to be careful as well not to assume things or to think of things that may not be. Sometimes we don't have all the facts. That's why the Word of God tells us, do not judge. Do not do. And also, as I tell people, do not throw stones at someone else, because remember, you live in a glass house too. And someone can throw a stone at you as well. We're not perfect. We're striving to do the things of God. And we should be careful that we don't judge other people, or even if, let's just say even if you get the facts, even if the facts were there, we're still not to condemn or to put down, but we're to try to help other people. Because all are tempted. And every now and then, we all give in to sin that we should not give in to. It says, all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Not that that should give us an excuse to continue to sin, but what it should do, it should say, wow, I'm sorry that person's going through it. Even if that person caused it upon themselves, we're still striving to help those people. Here, even though Joseph knew that what Mary was carrying was not his child, he still was not vindictive. He still didn't say, I'm going to show her. You know, and he didn't take matters in his own hand. He was going to do it quietly. It was between him and her, not between anybody else. And sometimes that's the way it should be, just between the two people. And all, again, all Joseph had to go on was either what Mary told him or what he assumed, and he wasn't sure about it all concerning it. And so we see here, being a righteous man and did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly, to do this between them and just move on in life. So his mind was all made up. Have you ever had that in your life where your mind was all made up? You go to bed and the next morning you wake up and it's something, maybe the Lord revealed something to you or something took place and say, wow, okay, maybe this is what I need to do rather than doing these things over here. I have many times. many times, here and home, many times. Go to sleep on it, and before you know it, hey, things have changed. Be careful. The second thing that we see in verses 20 through 23 is Joseph had his mind all made up, and he goes to sleep. Notice the dream that Joseph now is going to have by the Lord. And after he considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All of this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet, that is the Old Testament. And here, as the angel told him from Isaiah chapter 7 and verse 14, the virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. Awesome, isn't it? So here it is. Joseph, after having his mind all made up, he has his dream. I don't know. You know, we have our minds made up. Now, I've never had an angel visit me in my dreams. You know, I'm not even like Zechariah, who had an angel visit him, and others that we see where angels come along and visit you, when Mary had the angel come and visit her, and I don't know what I would think or say or do concerning if an angel visit us. Now, my wife tells the people the story when she was a teenager. She had a guardian angel help her, so I don't know. It's possible. Maybe we all do have guardian angels. I don't know. If that's the case, mine is working double overtime. concerning some of the stuff that I can get myself into. But anyhow, now Joseph is given the information. Now maybe this is the first time he's told that Mary and her pregnancy was not by another man, but by the power of the Holy Spirit. We don't know this. And so God wanted Joseph to be involved in the life of Mary, and also to be involved with the plan of salvation, to be there for her, to be her husband, to be a part of it as well. And notice, the angel here gives him all the information that he needs. Mary is pregnant because of the power of the Holy Spirit. Also, notice, he tells her she will give birth to a son, and you are to call his name Jesus. Now, Jesus' name is another name for Joshua. God will save. He will save, okay? Our salvation concerning what we see here. So, we see this, and notice he says, he will save his people from their sins. See, this is what people need today. Many people think they need money, they need homes, they need cars, they need all of these other possessions. But what people really need most importantly and first of all is a relationship with Jesus Christ and the salvation of their soul.
Amen.
Because you see, the salvation of your soul is forever. What we have and we possess is temporary. This building, our vehicles. How long does your vehicle last you? Not long, that's right, not long. How long does your clothes last you? Not long. You see, things are temporary, but salvation that comes from the Lord is forever. It doesn't go away. And Jesus says, those who I have in my hand, they will have forever. See, he's got you right here because he went on the cross to die for you. So God is sending the Lamb to be the sacrifice on the cross that will be for us to save his people from their sins. You see, you can't be saved from your sins by your works. It's impossible. The Word of God says that. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, not of works, lest any man should boast. See, many people are trying to work their way to heaven by their own effort. It doesn't work that way. If it did, nobody would get to heaven, because we would fall that short every time. It doesn't work. It's by grace. See, and that's the awesome thing. God said, I provided. And that's what he's telling Joseph here. I am sending the promised Messiah, and he will save his people from their sins. And notice he says, and this is to fulfill what the Lord said through the prophets. See, he's relating to them because Joseph knows the Old Testament. And he knows what the Old Testament said as he quotes Isaiah 7:14 in here, fulfilling the Old Testament. See, God fulfills his word. He fulfills it. Now, it may not be in your time or my time, but he's going to fulfill his word. And today, all we're waiting for is Jesus to come back again. When is that going to happen? We don't know. It just tells us to be ready. How can you be ready? By repenting of your sins and putting your trust and faith in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. That's how. By believing in him. Walking by faith, not by sight. And he may not come in our time, but he is coming one day. And the reason we know this is because the Bible tells us so. And the Bible is true, because everything has been fulfilled. Everything, except the coming of the Lord again. That's the only thing lacking now. And he may come at any time, and we need to be ready. So Joseph, he has given a clear direction to God as to what God wants him to do. See, God is speaking to him. And I would caution people, even today, that, you know, yeah, God can speak to us in dreams. He can speak to us through his word. He can speak to us through other people even. But make sure it is of God. Make sure it is God who's speaking and not just something that you want or something somebody else wants or things of God. You see, and notice, how do we know all of this is of God? Because it is to fulfill Old Testament scripture. Also, this brings glory to God, not to Joseph. This brings joy and happiness to all of Israel, as well as all of us Gentiles, everywhere. For all who put faith in Jesus Christ, this is the joy and happiness, you see, and this is what's going to happen. And again, you will call him, you go unto him, you call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. You see, again, Jesus is God who came in the flesh, born of a virgin. Amazing what God has done and what God accomplished through all of this, his plans, and revealing it to Joseph. And here, he relates to Joseph that what's taking place with Mary is God's plan. Was it Mary? It was God doing everything, using Mary. But now he wants to use Joseph as well. Just like he used Zechariah and Elizabeth. Just like he used Abraham and Sarah. And so many others that you may read about in both the Old and the New Testament. Just as he uses you and I to accomplish his will, to accomplish and fulfill what he wants done. Maybe telling someone about Jesus Christ, where you're at. A friend, a co-worker, whatever. You speaking, or maybe not even speaking. Just by you professing to be who you are in the Lord, and people seeing who you are, they say, wow, why is that person different? Of all that that person is going through, and you relating, saying, because of the Lord, because of Jesus in my heart and my life, because of what he has done for me. And that through that, people come to know Jesus Christ. Amazing. And so here we see Joseph being told all of this information, and now he has a choice, doesn't he? Now, what is Joseph going to do? As he has this dream and as God has spoken to him. Well, notice the obedience of Joseph after being spoken to by the angel concerning what is going to take place in verse 24 and 25. It says, when Joseph woke up, he did what the angel Lord had commanded him, and he took Mary home and his wife, but he had no union with her until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him, and he gave him the name Jesus. Amazing. Here we have it. Obedience. This is what God wants from all of his servants, from all of us, to obey his word, to obey his command, and what he wants. Noah, just think what would have happened if Noah would not obey the command of God when God told him, I want you to build an ark, big old ship, big old boat, and here's how I want you to do it. And it took him 120 years to build it, and he never gave up. He and his sons and his daughters-in-law and his wife, faithful, did it. They were obedient to the word of God. Abraham, obedient. And we have so many others as well. Think about Daniel or Daniel's three friends, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And there they were going to be in a fiery furnace and obedient to the word of God. Obey. We will worship our God and not that statue that you have raised up, Nebuchadnezzar. Even if you throw us in there and kill us, we don't care. We're going to be obedient to the word of God. And we have so many others as well. But in keeping with his righteous character, as he is a righteous man, he knew that what he dreamed was not an illusion, or not just a figment of his imagination. It was actually God, through the angel, speaking to him. Just as if an angel arrived in person like it did with Zechariah, like it did with Mary, and like it did with many others as well when they came. You know, he knew it. And immediately, what did he do? He obeyed the word of God. He obeyed God's commands and God's direction. And he took Mary home and his wife, and he did not have any relation with her. That is important. And the reason that is important is twofold here. One is that she is pregnant with the Son of God. But two, to fulfill. And notice what it says. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son. They'll call him Emmanuel. If he had had relations with her while she was pregnant with Jesus, then she would not be a virgin to give birth to Jesus. She would no longer be a virgin. And you see, that would null and void the Old Testament scripture, what it says. The virgin will be with child. And so, he had no relations with her until afterwards. After Jesus was born, Joseph and Mary had other children. Contrary to what some religions do teach and what they do say, they did. We know for a fact that they had at least four other sons, and maybe two or three other daughters. We don't know because they don't give us the daughters' names. But if you go back and you read in Matthew and also in Luke, you get the names of Joseph and Mary's children. So they had at least, I would say, anywhere from 6 to 7 children after Jesus was born. And so we have this where the Lord blessed Joseph and Mary's union afterwards. But again, what we need to understand here and what we need to see concerning Joseph was, again, as I mentioned, he was obedient to the things of God. He was beside Mary during her pregnancy. He was there taking her to Bethlehem and doing the things that a husband needs to do, knowing that what it was going on was indeed of God. And on the 8th day, in keeping with the command and with the law, he went and sent, and they brought Jesus to the temple. And there on the 8th day, they circumcised him, and Joseph and Mary gave their son a name, by the name of Jesus. Again, the evidence of faith is believing the word of God, is believing it and acting upon it. And this is what Joseph did. He believed what the word of God says, and he acted upon it. Noah believed the things of God and acted upon it. Abraham believed the words of God and acted upon it as well. And the word of God tells us to believe upon the one that he has sent, and you will have eternal life. So the question is do you have eternal life? Do you know Jesus Christ as your Lord and as your Savior? As we're now in the season of Christmas and celebrating the birth, and we set a time aside to celebrate the birth of Jesus. Do you truly celebrate it, and do you know him? He was in a manger, and then later he died on the cross. But now, does he live in your heart and in your life? And do you know him for all eternity? If not, you come and acknowledge Jesus Christ as your Lord and as your Savior. Let us stand. Almighty God, as we come now, Lord, and if there's anyone here this morning whom you have said unto them, come unto me, I pray. I pray, Almighty God, that they will come and they will heed your voice. They will heed what you tell them to do, and they will listen. And like Joseph, like Mary, and like others, they will be obedient to your word, and they will come unto you at this time. We ask it in the name of Jesus. Amen. If God has spoken to you today, you come as we sing hymn number 314. Is that right, 314? Yeah. 314, Whosoever Will. Sometimes as we journey in this life and as we walk, sometimes it's hard to walk by faith. When we see so much going on in our family's lives or our lives or things happening throughout the chaos, the division and so much. But we need to continue just to walk by faith and not by sight. And we need to be obedient to the word of God and not to the things of the world or even our opinion if it contradicts that of the word of God. Obey God's word. You'll be happier for it, and you'll find joy, peace, and happiness through his word. I pray that you know him. If not, we're praying for you. If you would like to have more information or would like to know more about being saved, come talk to me. We can sit down and we can talk together concerning the things of God. But we're praying for you as well. Again, we invite you to come back this coming Wednesday. We have Wednesday night Bible study from 6:30 to 7:30. Prior to that, about 6 o'clock or so or earlier, from 6:30 or 5 minutes to 6 or 6 to 6:30, we have food. And you can come join us for that. If not, we invite you to come back next Sunday as we will have Sunday school slash Bible study from 9 to 10. 10:15, and then worship service at 10:30 as well. Again, we'll have fellowship in the back at the conclusion of this, as we have a lot of food there, and I hope everyone will stay. Again, if you need any calendars, there are at least six of them left. I don't know how long they'll last, but they're all six there, and they're $5 each. You can have that. If you need the financial report for the month of November, there are some in the back. We got one last week for October. This is for November. So if you need one of those, you can go ahead and pick one of those up as well. Pray God's blessing upon each and every one, and I hope everyone stays. Al, lead us in a closing prayer.
Heavenly Father, again, we come before you, thanking you all that you've done for us. Thanking you for your word, Father, and knowing you can deal with each and every one of us, no matter what situation we're in, what's happening in our lives, Father. You're there. You can help us. You can lift us up. Father, I pray again for those that weren't able to be here today, that bless them wherever they are, whatever they're doing. Let them know that they are in our prayers. Again, thank you, and I pray that everyone remembers the reason for the season. It's in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
I'm looking forward to getting